Hi everyone! In this video, I want to talk about my favorite Polychromos pencils. I'm still not completely familiar with the whole set. I am more familiar with my Prismacolors, of course, but I already managed to find some favorites and I really want to share them with you. Let's start from the cream. For me, cream is a pencil which I use each time when I want to add warmth to the picture, when I want to create effect of the sun reflection of the object, when I want to create sun-kissed skin or reflection from the gold or from the fire on the objects, like I used it here when I wanted to create a very pale yellow reflection from the golden jewelry. Thanks to the transparency of the pigment, I can slowly layer it, and layer after layer I can get desired intensity of yellow color, and still in the same time everything looks quite natural. I can use it on top of other colors when I want to get a warmer picture and to add sunlight to all objects. I can combine it with many other colors, like I combine it here with Naples yellow and with any other yellow colors. Also, it looks nice together with yellowish green colors from Polychromos set, for example with May green. You can easily use this two colors when you create a very fresh new young leaves during spring, or you can combine it with rose colors. Here I mixed it with rose carmine and it also looks good. If you follow my color alongs, you know that I love to use deco yellow from Prismacolors set. If I need to indicate sunlight or highlights when I color with Prismas, and almost in the same way I used cream. Initial cream color seems paler than deco yellow, but when you gradually start to build layer after layer, in the end, you can get quite intense pastel yellow color, and in the same time it's not over bright, nothing neon into it, very natural looking, so that's why I love to use it and I use it quite quickly. Next, I want to talk about colors which I use for the fair skin tone. I discovered that for me, coloring faces with Polychromos is much easier than coloring with Prismacolors. My basic colors for the fair skin tone is Light Flesh and Cinnamon. And again, I believe that it's easier for me to work with them because pigment is transparent for the oil-based pencils. I used Light Flesh here as a basic tone, and by varying pressure on the pencil, I was able to go to the darker areas and then to mix it with brown and cinnamon colors. And with using very light pressure, I was able to go to the highlighted, almost uncolored area, where later I added a little bit of white to smooth everything. So again, with just two pencils, by varying pressure and with working in layers, you can get a pretty natural skin tone. When I was quite adventurous and when I tried to do pale blue or pale lilac shadows on the skin, it also looked good together with these colors, again thanks to the transparency through the light layer of this Light Flesh. It was still visible my pale blue shadows, and Everything looked without any stains, so I'm much more satisfied with my portraits when I color them with Polychromos. Prismacolor set has also a couple of very helpful colors like light peach or deco peach or nectar colors if you want to color fair skin, but it's slightly harder for me to work with them because they are opaque. I tend to press harder on Prisma, so each time when I do a darker shadow or I mix it with bluer color for the shadows, quite often I got not very pleasant stains. In my opinion, Polychromos pencils are closer to the real fair skin tone, and Prismacolor pencils are slightly more pinkish or slightly more reddish, and quite often in the end all my girls looked too red-faced or too pink, like dolls, not like a real fair skin tone. Recently I discovered for myself that it also looks good if I do initial coloring with light flash and cinnamon from Polychromos, and on the last step I can use Prismacolor light peach to blend and to get nice waxy shining on the portrait. So I use it as a blender on top of Polychromos. Next, my absolute favorite is green gold, and I'm so happy that one of my viewers left me a comment about this pencil because I haven't had it in my initial set. So I purchased it open stock, and now it's my absolute must-have for coloring golden objects. I can combine it with brighter yellow colors like cadmium yellow or cadmium yellow or Naples yellow to create shadows on the golden surface. I can use darker colors like Bister and Van Dyke brown. They look nice together. In my opinion, it creates perfect basic tone for the gold. I don't like bright yellow, like new and shiny gold. It looks quite cheap. And with adding darker colors into the green gold, you can get more weathered old gold, which is slightly muted, but still, color is very beautiful. And you also can combine it with pale green colors, like I combine it with cadmium yellow lemon, or I combined it with May green. It also very helpful for coloring fall leaves, like I did here when I mixed May green, green gold and olive green yellow. The closest pencil which I have in Prismacolor set is Artichoke and also green ochre. I love both those colors. They are very short in my Prismacolor set, so I am very happy that now I can use green gold instead of my almost finished Prismacolor pencils. All golden elements on these pictures I colored using mostly green gold and adding some additional colors to it. I think that gold color looks quite nice. It's bright, but in the same time it's very natural looking. Next, colors which I really appreciate in Polychromos set and pencils which I started to purchase first is dark green and mid-tone green colors. I was a little bit unhappy with dark green colors in Prismacolor. I don't think that they look natural. Even dark green isn't very attractive. The only attractive color in Prismacolor is Prussian green. So when I started to color more in flower year, I started to collect dark green Polychromos pencils. For now, my favorite dark and mid-tone greens are chromium oxide green, pine green, juniper green, and permanent green olive. Couple of them are slightly more yellowish. Pine green is slightly colder, so you can choose appropriate lighter colors from Polychromos set, but I think that with light colors like May green, they all combine very good and very natural looking color combos. If you want to darken them deeper, you can combine them with indigo or with Payne's gray, and you got nice shadows on the leaves. Let's compare color of the dark green from Prismacolors with my favorite four dark green polychromoses. Before I got Prismacolor Prussian green, I had only dark green in my smaller set, so I really was very unhappy with dark leaves. That's why I started to collect Polychromos pencils, and they helped me so much in coloring flower year. I was able to color even the whole page with dark colors, but thanks to the slightly different hues, as I said, some of them are more yellowish, some of them are more bluish, I was able to get a nice variety of different leaves. Usually I tend to use more warm green colors, but sometimes it's really nice to add to the bunch of warm green leaves something colored with gray-green color. That's why Earth Green is definitely one of my favorites. It slightly reminds me about Celadon Green or Jade Green from Prismacolors, but I love it because it's harder, so it's easier to color things like pine trees when you really need to color very tiny things, very tiny leaves, so I use it quite often to make nice contrast between warm green and cold green colors in flower year compositions. It also quite versatile. You can mix earth green with May green, you can mix it with pale blue colors, or you can mix it with cold gray colors, and everything will look very nice. So it's a start for many and many color combos. I forgot to mention that May green is another one of my favorite green colors. Here I have Albrecht Dürer, because I wanted to test how watercolor Faber-Castell pencils work, but color is still the same, and I also love my May green, so it's another of my favorites. I am totally in love with the next pencil. Light cobalt turquoise is beautiful by itself. I love all blue-green colors and I tend to use them quite often, but the best thing for the light cobalt turquoise is that it's a start of many and many different color combos. You can go more to the green colors if you use light cobalt turquoise than cobalt green and deep cobalt green. So everything will go from the pale blue green to the deeper green colors. Or otherwise, you can start blue color combo. So I used cobalt, light cobalt turquoise, then halo turquoise or even bluish turquoise, and then I slowly go to the Prussian blue, quite intense blue color, and still everything looks together quite nice. Also, I love to mix light cobalt turquoise with sky blue, or light cobalt turquoise with green colors, for example May green or light green. I can imagine using two first color combos for coloring ocean waters, for example. You know that sometimes waves are more greenish and sometimes waves look more bluish, especially in the deeper part of the ocean. So you can use light cobalt turquoise as a base, and then to add a little bit of green and a little bit of blue, darker colors together with it. I played a lot with this pencil when I colored my sleeping dragon in Zemlya Snowa. I believe that I used almost the whole palette of light blue-green, middle blue-green and dark blue-green colors, and in the end everything looks quite well balanced here. And I believe that light cobalt turquoise is the main reason why my dragon looks so nice. Next, we will go to the pink colors. I love the whole range of pink, carmine, magenta, crimson and violet colors in Polychromos set, so the whole line here. I love them all, but I believe that pink colors in Polychromos are slightly more complicated, slightly more interesting than pink colors in Prismacolor set. I love pink and hot pink from Prismacolor set, but now I think that Polychromos pinks are much more interesting. First, when I just got Polychromos set, I didn't understand why they include so many almost identical pink pencils. But then, gradually, I started to appreciate such an ample variety of pink colors, because each pink has slightly different hue into it. There are pinks which are more close to the violet, pinks which are closer to red colors, and it makes creating color combos much, much easier. And also I love that they still looks not over bright, and I really quite careful with using pink. I don't like neon pink colors, so that's why slightly muted, more exquisite pink colors from Polychromos is much more easier for me to use. My favorite colors are light magenta, pink madder lake, and rose carmine, but as I said, I love the whole variety of pink colors in the set. Light magenta is color which I love to combine with violet colors like manganese violet or purple violet. So if I need to go from pink to violet colors, I always start my color combo from light magenta. Light magenta looks nice even with orange. Pink madder lake I love to combine with crimson or light red violet, so it's something between violet and red. Rose carmine is my favorite color for doing very natural looking blush, and I love to combine it with burnt carmine or magenta because it has more reddish tint into it. And finally, we arrive at black and Payne's gray. When I first got Polychromos set, I was confused. Black wasn't exactly very black as I was used to Prismacolor black, and a lot of dark colors, dark browns, dark blues or dark greens wasn't enough dark for me. But then when I started to look at various tutorials or to learn how to use pencils for my colorings, I started to realize that black Polychromos and Payne's gray Polychromos can serve as a perfect underpaint, as a first layer if you need to darken and to deepen colors. Thanks to the transparency of the oil-based pencils, you can use them on top of the initial color and still Initial color will be visible through the layer of black or Payne's gray, but it will be darkened. And shadow, which you can add in this way, looks quite natural. For example, let me add a slight shadow using opaque black Prismacolor. It will look awful. Imagine if I would decide to make such opaque black shadows on leaves. And if I add black shadow with transparent polychromos, it looks much, much softer. I can darken color, but green is still visible. So for me, it's a great way to correct my mistake. I know that one of my problems with coloring is that my pictures in the end quite often lack nice contrast, nice difference between light and dark colors, and picture always looks more interesting if you have this bigger contrast between light and darker areas. So now, by using Payne's gray for lighter color or black for darker colors, I can simply apply layer on top of the areas which I want to darken, where I want to deepen shadows, and in this way I can correct my mistake. You can see that here I add Payne's gray around this flower, I add shadow to the leaves, and flower immediately started to pop up on the darker background. So sometimes I use these two colors as an underpaint. So I start to color with them, and then on top of this created shadow, I use the main color of the object. Or I can use them vice versa on the last step, when I realized that I need stronger contrasts. Look here, I also added some stronger shadow, and in my opinion, flower look more interesting. Now, in Prismacolor set, I used 90% and 70% French grays in the same way, when I need to darken shadows on the last step and to add some depth to my picture. That were my favorite Polychromos pencils. As I said, I am still not completely familiar with all colors, with color combos, but I gradually, step by step, start to appreciate Polychromos more and more. I thank you for watching, and if you share with me which Polychromos pencils are your favorite, and for which elements you love to use them, I will be very grateful.